The Oppo Find X3 Neo is a phone that appeals on many different levels. Whether you're looking for something that takes great photos or that just looks great, it's a lot cheaper than the Pro model, but it might have made just one compromise too many for along the way. I like its superb screen, excellent camera, stylish design. It has no wireless charging, it has an older processor and no waterproofing. Is the Oppo Find X3 Pro a little too rich for your blood? Well, then may we introduce the Oppo Find X3 Neo, the mid-range model in the line below the Pro but above the Oppo Find X3 Lite in terms of light and performance. In many ways, it gets close to the ideal mix of affordability and power, but exactly where that sweet spot is tends to be different from everyone. Pitting the Pro directly against the Neo in the Oppo Find X3 range, the Neo we are looking at here has a slower Qualcomm Snapdragon 365 processor, a smaller 6.55-inch screen, and a less impressive rear camera. For this and other more minor compromises, you pay not insubstantial £400 less in the UK. The official retail price of the Neo is £699. As well as an alternative to the Oppo Find X3 Pro, this handset is a successor of sorts to the Oppo Find X2 Neo, a phone that I was very much impressed with last year. Not a huge amount has changed on the newer model, though it packs more battery capacity, a faster processor, and a slightly improved rear camera. The design has been upgraded too, in our opinion, but the Find X2 Neo still represents a good deal if you can find it on sale for a competitive price. The highlight of the phone are undoubtedly its design, including a superb looking screen and a quad lens rear camera. The camera might be a downgrade from the Pro model, but it's not a huge step down, and it's still capable of capturing some great photos and video for you. The Neo even takes low light scenes in a stride, and there are many other phones at this price point that are this good in the camera department. Speaking of price, it's perhaps just a touch on the high side, considering on the phone comes carrying a processor that launched last year and last wireless charging and IP68 waterproofing. You are spending a lot of money to get it. You can pick up the Pixel 5 and the OnePlus 9 for slightly less, the iPhone 12 mini for the same price, and the Samsung Galaxy S21 for a little bit more. There are a lot of great phones around for this amount of money. The strength of the composition could be the biggest problem for the Oppo Find X3 Neo, because otherwise it's a fantastic phone that really enjoyed using. If you are in the market for one of the best phones around this year, then I would recommend taking a long, hard look at this one. You can now pre-register your interest in the Oppo Find X3 Neo, but the phone doesn't actually ship until April 14. When it does arrive, it will cost you £299, around $950 and AUD 1,250, putting the family on the border between mid-range and flagship. In the UK, you can get the handset direct from Oppo and from Network, including 3 and EE, but there's no sign of the handset going on sale in either the US or Australia. Its design, it has a stylish matte back, light and curve, no waterproofing. The Oppo Find X3 Neo is a fantastic looking phone, it's there we see it, even easier on the eyes than the more expensive Pro model, with a textured matte back to the casing that feels great to touch and doesn't show every single fingerprint. We have understated star-like back color for our Pro model, though a more glossy Galaxy Silver option is also available. It's hard to find a single fault in aesthetic of the phone. The phone display is only interrupted by the point hole kept out of the way in the top left corner, while the rear camera array looks neat and compact. There's a noticeable camera bump, but it's not a major problem, and even the Oppo logo is tastefully handled. The fingerprint sensor is embedded under the phone display, which again helps the minimal and clean aesthetic of the phone. The curves and the line of the handset are all in the right place, with a slight curve to the side of the screen. The button power on the right, volume on the left, as we look at the Neo, are small but easily accessed. The overall size feels like it eats something of a sweet spot as far as today's smartphone market goes. Big enough to hold this phone, but not so big that you are going to struggle to hold it one hand. Those dimensions in full are 159.9mm by 72.5mm by 8mm, that's 6.3 inches by 2.9 inches by 0.3 inches, and that's 184 grams. The phone is just a touch lighter than the Pro. Another difference from the Pro is that there is no IP68 rated protection against water and dust. That custom code has to come from somewhere after all, so you have to be a little more careful when carrying the phone along the beach or across the bathroom. One of the best plugins we can give to the Oppo Find X3 Neo is that it feels like a premium phone when you pick it up and use it. It's not exactly a cheap phone of course, but it can definitely hold its own against the Samsung Galaxy and Apple iPhone handset of the moment, which is a credit to what Oppo has managed to put together here. Display: 6.55 inch AMOLED screen, 90Hz refresh rate, support HDR 10 plus in apps. The display on the Oppo Find X3 Neo is something of a stunner, brighter and vivid and crisp. A 6.55 inch corner to corner runs at a resolution of 1080 by 2400 pixels, which is all you really need at this size. The 90Hz refresh rate adds a touch of extra smoothness, while the HDR 10 plus support means colors always stay well balanced and details always stay visible in streaming apps like Netflix and Prime Video. There's nothing bad to say at all about the screen, though you need to be a fan of displays with a slight slope around the sides to really appreciate the Neo. The only interruption is the punch hole for the selfie camera, and the phone comes with a thin transparent protector on the screen as well, which you can order leave in place or peel off. Ramp up the brightness to maximum, a whopping 1100 nits according to Oppo, and the phone is very much usable outdoors in bright sunlight. You can also make tweaks in display section of the phone settings. There are cooler and warmer options for the screen temperature as well as the standard default, while there is also a setting for reducing your eye exposure to blue light late at night. Camera: quad lens camera perform well in low light, ultra-wide at 2x optical zoom. We like what Oppo has done with the rear camera on the Find X3 Pro, and the Find X3 Neo holds up well in this department too. Even if the specs of the cameras have been dialed down a little, there's a quad lens 50MP wide, a 13MP telephoto, a 16MP ultra-wide and a 2MP macro rear camera here. There's also a 32MP wide selfie camera on the front. That camera 50MP IMX766 lens is the same one as on the Pro model, custom made by Sony for Oppo, and it does an impressive job of capturing light and detail. The photos captured by the rear camera are balanced, bright and sharp, with plenty of detail showing when you examine them closely, and natural color levels throughout. Shutter speed is fast, focus is almost instantaneous, and in every challenge put to the Oppo Find X3 Neo, manage to get a very good shot. The ultra wide mode is there to cram more into your frame if you need to, and thankfully colors aren't distorted too much along the way, while the telephoto lens offers 2x optical zoom for getting closer to whatever is it you are snapping. Low light performance is fantastic too, with or without night mode enabled. Even in very dark scenes, the Neo's rear camera is able to grab lots of detail and color from the scene, and it can even pick out the stars in the night sky. It can occasionally have focus issues with focus and noise, but overall the results get are out of fault. It works on the video capture, which goes up to 4K resolution at 30 frames per second. The footage you get from the phone is smooth and polished, and Oppo has deployed a few new tricks to make sure colors and details are well balanced. Video subjects stay in focus and low light scenes are still visible. Everything considered, is definitely one of the best camera packages you can get on a phone at this price. Specs and performance: powered by the Snapdragon 865 and impressive 12GB of RAM, no issues with auto game. The Oppo Find X3 Neo is powered by Snapdragon 865 chipset from Qualcomm, which don't forget was a flagship CPU for Android from last year, at least until the A65 Plus showed up. In other words, the processor might be a year old, but it's one of the best in the business, and everything spread along very nicely on this phone. The impressive spec continues with the FT12GB of RAM and 256GB of internal storage, which isn't expandable. We're talking power user specs here, and even if the phone is slightly lower than the Snapdragon 888 Power Pro model, we don't think more users are particularly going to notice the difference. It's the same story with running video editing app, opening up multiple browsers or trying to jump quickly between apps. You are going to have to work very hard to use up all the power memory that the Oppo Find X3 Neo has at its disposal. No matter why, you might well reasonably ask why you need the Snapdragon 888 processor when the Snapdragon 865 is still such a good performer. 5G is on the board as it's pretty much the norm now, and the software is Oppo's own colors on top of Android 11. It's not the worst Android scheme I've ever seen, but nor does it have the clean and simple feel of stock Android. The Oppo Find X3 Neo doesn't come carry the very best spec that you found on an Android phone this year, but they get pretty close and it can definitely hold its own with the top flagship. Most users will find that there's more than enough power at their disposal here. Battery life: 4500 mAh capacity battery, comfortably last a day, no wireless charging support. The Oppo Find X3 Neo comes with a respectable battery capacity of 4500 mAh, and in our test it comfortably lasted through a day of regular use with some time to spare. Part of the lack of battery anxiety around the Oppo Find X3 Neo comes with 65W charging speed. You can plug it in and get a full charge from zero in just over 30 minutes, which is pretty astonishing when you think about it. When charging so fast, you don't have to worry quite so much about being cut short. Just a 5-minute charge before you go out of the door is going to make a significant difference. There's no wireless charging though, which is a shame at this price. Wireless charging may lack the speed of standard charging over a USB cable, but you can beat it in terms of convenience, and it's a feature that you find on many mid-range phones at the moment. So the Neo is something of an outlier in this regard. You should buy the Oppo Find X3 Pro if the Pro is too expensive for you. The Find X3 Neo is a downgrade from the Find X3 Pro, but significantly cheaper too, and we think that a lot of trade-offs are one that you are going to be willing to make. You want great videos and photos. There is no doubt that the quad lens camera on the Oppo Find X3 Neo is one of the best around at this point, no matter what kind of lighting you are shooting with. You need a phone that lasts. While this asset is by no means a game changer when it comes to battery life, it's above average in how long it lasts between charges, and that 65W charging is very welcome too. Don't buy it if you want the best specs around. While the Snapdragon 865 is a very capable chipset, it's also a year old now. The Oppo Find X3 Neo is still nice and fast, but age will catch up with it more than quickly than the Pro model. You are clumsy with your phone. One of the callbacks that Oppo has made there is removing the dustproof and waterproofing for the new model, and that is likely to be important to a lot of you. So I'll come to the end of our review video. Please like, subscribe, comment on this video, and turn on those post notifications so you get notified whenever I release a new video. Peace. Stay blessed.